Vediamo, ok, siamo live, raga. Va bene. Allora, condividiamo schermo. Vedete il mio schermo?
Sì.
Vedete la prima slide? Sì, ok.
Sì.
Raga, allora, se avete dubbi, domande, perplessità, non si blocca qualcosa, non si vede qualcosa. Please scrivetelo su o scrivetemi in privato o sul gruppo perché non riesco a guardare o se qualcuno non può parlare fai commenti, per favore me lo scrivete perché non riesco a guardare i commenti. Ok? So, Donzelletti. First thing, what we saw during this bellissima transition, this is the fourth and the penultimo before last transition webinar, because the next one will do synergy and the last will be, as I was saying yesterday, commission chat. So, in general, what we saw in the first three webinars was mainly based on the new value proposition, which is the marketing role, all the part about how to attract and how to sell, so the main marketing strategy, inbound marketing, and integrated marketing. That is something super mega important, because if you work a lot with integrated marketing, all your process of marketing will be very easy. But if you don't work with integrated marketing, of course, it will be more difficult to get the results. And last but not least, in the last webinar, we saw how to sell to the different customer personas, and especially we had a brief moment in understanding all the part of the evaluation stage, the marketing analysis. That I hope is going on, but we will have a space also later to review that one, like in general, how it's working or how it's not, what is not working. Va bene? Sì,
Va
no?
bene, va bene, va bene.
Ok. Question, did you have other spaces about peer-to-peer transition? I know that the girls, you did chat about tracking tools. I don't know if you are sharing between the others also other things. I know that some of you put the tracking tools under the folder of the transition. I don't know if you want to start sharing other type of contents or tools, whatever, like the drive, the folder is really for you. So if you think that is needed to share other things, just tell me or you can add whatever you need, like really it's for you. Do you want to share other things, or are you thinking to share other things? No, boh. Braga.
Go.
Va bene.
No, the problem is nothing, nothing.
Nothing for me.
Di Gabriel.
No, a little bit of disagio. I start to laugh a lot.
Why?
Because nobody answered to you.
Grazie. No, ma ragazzi, I think it's very important. I don't know who of you were in the chat of I remember it was, I think, Noemi, Sophie. I don't know which other of you were in the chat of tracking tool. Boh.
No. John, non ho sentito cosa hai detto.
Gli altri di voi eravate nella chat in cui avete parlato come lavorare meglio con il tracking tool.
Io, Chiara.
Ok. I don't know if it was useful, but I think that in general, sharing between each other all these things will really help you to start really with super huge knowledge in general. So if you think also that you need other type of peer-to-peer transition. I know that, for example, some of you, I know Anto, Sophie, Angelica, you did also with Pietro. So I don't know, like, if you think that there are some topics that you would like to discuss, just tell me and we can understand how to go deeply, or if there is someone that have more knowledge on that, it can be me or some consultant, some of you, that can help more. Okay?
Okay.
Okay.
Va bene, so the agenda, we review a little bit what we did in the last three webinars. If you didn't check the webinars, please check them because they're very important. And now, okay, you know that to sell, we need to know what we sell. So before we go a little bit deeply again, we just review them, the value proposition, the customer personas, and IR. So, again, as all the listening webinars and in general these webinars and the transition, what I ask you is to be present, to ask if you have doubts, to be accountable always, and of course, as I was saying before, to like do it together, because as we know from our bellissima identity, if we collaborate to each other, it's really be better. So, first thing to review our products. Who of you, like everyone here, saw and have clear 100% the new value propositions? See? No? I never saw them.
I'm a little bit. Ho fatto anche la LEC su questo.
Bravissimo.
Me too. Me too.
Again, just briefly, what there is new, if you can say new. But it, as really written in the proposition, is the connection with the SDGs, the diversification of the product for GV. For G, we are underlining more all the entrepreneurial side. And again, here we are underlining also the different sub-products. And for DT, also here we are underlining the different sub-products. Very important for GT, and you will also see under the new value, under the new customer personas, is the underlining of this idea of first step in the world of the job, of the work. And this is very, very important. Again, who of you saw the national customer personas that were in the last newsletter?
Me.
Yeah, I saw them.
Okay.
I saw them only for OGV.
Okay.
Oh yeah, me too, because we focus on that, so.
Me too. Joe?
Esatto.
Joe, where are you?
Joe, you are okay?
Raga, che disagio. Giorgia. Miau.
Amazing.
No, raga, aspetta, scriviamo sul gruppo.
Ho già scritto.
Ok.
È morta.
È morta.
Gio.
Ok. Sembra un sintetizzatore.
Giorgia,
la nuova tastiera elettronica.
Is everything ok?
Ordina anche tu la tastiera.
Adesso sì.
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 Ci siamo preoccupati per la tua incolumità. No, sorry. Okay. We're in diretta, so we need to speak English.
Bravissimo.
Ok, sorry. I think that I will check another time this direct, because it's very funny.
Di nuovo morto.
Gio.
Oh my god.
I love this type of webinar.
So, Ragazzi, ma solo al marketing succede queste cose.
Io dico che per fare meeting ci vuole mezz'ora perché le persone non ci riescono a collegare. È proprio il marketing, proprio di Ari.
Raga, ci ricordiamo che siamo in diretta, quindi potremmo fare un miau tutti insieme.
Raga,
vai,
è
Gabriel, tre. Siete.
No, vai. Raga, vai.
Io con Alba, cazzo.
Uno, due, tre.
Miau.
Okay, chi è Anna? Ciao Anna, miau.
Miau.
Io non ti sento.
Non sei marketing.
Anna, cazzo fai? Anna.
Oh. Giorgia.
Raga, mi sentite?
Sì, sì, sì.
Ok. Faccio un time out che danno una mano.
Mi sollici quando si blocca.
Sì, mi metto in moto.
Grazie.
Ok, raga.
No.
Otta.
Ma in che senso?
Raga, perché è uscita?
Facciamo una colletta, compriamo un...
Ma modem.
Esatto. Compriamo un modem a Giorgia.
Dal mio.
Ma cazzo.
Parolaccia.
Ah.
Raga, mi sentite?
Sì.
Sì, sì.
Ok. Sono focus perché non è possibile un disagio del genere. Ok. In case there is Anna now that is, she's telling me if it's working or not. Ok?
Ok.
Ok. Ok, first thing about customer personas, come back to what we did and what we didn't do. Ok, how we did the space during Planco, we divided into groups and we had a draft of the customer personas. And after in the office, I had meeting with the girls and Ale to finalize them and to put in a final output that is the one that you are seeing. What is needing now? I don't know if you saw also the booklet to define your local customer personas, is that you go deeply to each of them. Then you understand very, very deeply, based on your market and IR analysis, how to define your local customer personas based on each of them. Parenthesis. For sure, you will have in your market each of them, or at least, for example, for OGV, at least two of them. For example, one thing that I would like to underline is like that, for example, I don't know if you remember, but I was explaining in the first webinar, this benefit of the fact in Isaac in Italy is not the main benefit in our customer, but anyway, it's one of the benefits that we are selling. So it's very important anyway to understand who are the customer that buy our products for that. Questionissima. How is you with your market analysis and your local customer definition from 1 to 10?
This morning I did Synergia with my OGX and we define our customer. We start with the ER.
No, I didn't get it. ER. IR.
IR, vabbè, it's the same. Okay.
What do you mean you start with IR?
We finish with the market analysis.
Mm-hmm.
And we define our customer persona. And now we start to analyze, to do LC to LC.
Okay. Remember that to understand your local customer persona, you should combine both the market analysis and IR analysis, no?
Yes.
Others?
I need to define the customer personas in with the meeting in 20th of January with the OGX. But now we don't have a really plan.
Others that you would like to share?
Okay, question. Which is your main struggles now? Like, I don't know if you, I hope, and in case you didn't, go to check, but in general about, for example, customer interviews and definition of customer personas, which is your more struggle? Like, what are you not understanding, or what you are having more confusion, or you want more clarification on?
Okay.
Can you repeat, please?
When you, like, for example, I know that you are, you, I hope you are finishing the customer interview, so the market analysis, and in general, like, seeing that.
Problems.
Again.
What is stopping you now to really understand or to finish the market analysis or to define your local customer personas? Like, which is your main struggles or what is making you more confusion?
For us, I think that everything is clear at the moment. So I hope that the no problem in future.
Someone else? Raga?
We have to define our customer personas because, and we don't have a meeting, mm-hmm. and so I think now it's all is clear, but I don't do it because we have no time in this week because I, Elisa, and Davide have a exam, and so I hope to define our customer persona the next week.
Okay. In general, Raga, what I really would like from your side is that you really go deeply and understand in very specific situation the national customer personas and the book that we give you for the step-by-step of the definition. And if you don't have clear neither a small detail, just ask me or to Roxy or to Cree, okay? Like, okay. Really, we are, because at the end, we will see also in Winko, we will see also in the next webinars, but you have to arrive at Winko very, very clear who is your market and which is your customer personas in your local market. Because if you don't have this clear, you will affrontare a very difficult summer peak. Because as you know, you cannot sell the products if you don't have clear to who to sell and to why to sell to them. Okay?
Okay.
Okay, okay.
Okay, again. Also to connect what I was saying also today in the group. To know your products, like you don't have to know just your product to sell, but also the product and the country partners, the entity partners. So here, and you will see also in the output, I put you the links of the IR tools. And I will try also to show to you in a second, vediamo se la faccio. E quale cazzo è Cristo? This.
In English, okay. Please.
Sorry. Here, can you see the page?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, yes.
These are the two links that you will see for the IR tools. I hope that you have already saw these things in case very bad, but now you know. Here you can find all the projects in general, and for example, you can find also the booklets. What there is interesting here, for example, in each page, in the search, in the portfolio, in the booklet, is that you can also find materials to understand better the project, the national project you are selling, or in general the country. Okay, but because it's very important, like, I don't know, sometimes there is also this problem, tra virgolette, that when you are selling a project in a country partner, you find people that are more interested in the country partner. This is wrong, because you have to sell the project, not the country. But in case, you have to know the country also. And here for OGT, and for OG and OGT, you can also find also in the future the premium project, CRI, Here, she updates always the premium projects for the months. And you also find, yes, the country list, the JDs, and this is in general the IR tool. You have two IR tools, one for OG and OGT, and the other for OGV. And yes, I really suggest you to go deeply in each of them and to go and check. Like, they are very, very useful to understand for you and for your members and team leaders, which is the entity partners, and also how to promote each of them. For example, I will give you one example. When me and Roxy, we were defining the portfolio for GV customer personas for December and January. I hope you saw it. Cristo santo. Cavolo. Vabbè. When we were defining me and Roxy the portfolio for GV for December and January, we were checking here, we were checking their portfolio to understand how to combine the customer personas with the projects. Okay? And this is very, very important. Who of you never saw it? Don't worry, I will not kill you.
I never saw this.
Me too.
Me too.
Okay. Me too. Now you saw it, and you will always lose it.
Yeah, yes. But okay, niente, nothing. You will share with us.
Sì, I will share with you this.
Okay, thank you.
And in general, what I want to underline to you are the main country partners. Just one clarification. What will happen is that for summer, we have like our top partners that are Brazil, like for GV are Brazil, Colombia, Turkey, Poland, India, and Indonesia. And what will happen is then when we will have defined its local customer personas, what Roxy is doing from her side is that she's having chat to align each customer persona to other country partners, okay? So when in Winco, she will present to OGV, but like we have to understand also how to present for both OGV and marketing in case if it will not be during the common space, I will present to you. But there will be also specific country partners based on the customer personas because they will be based on the project that they are offering. At the same time, for OGV, you know that the main strategy for OGV is the product package. And the product package is mainly based on the two customer personas, Crea and Potentia. And the main country partners are Brazil, Egypt, Romania, and India. We replaced Brazil with Bahrain because we were not having so much result with Bahrain. And also from the IG point of view, we were having some troubles. And an important information is that January and February is the focus for OGT teaching, and the main country partners for OGT teaching for January and February is Turkey and India. For OGT, as you know, the process time is different. We have also to sell 3-4 weeks before the realizations, and it's very important to understand that the main focus for OGT for January and February from marketing point of view, but also from OGT point of view, is teaching. And yes, also about them, you find also the opportunities under the IR tool that I show you. And in case if you didn't have clear this, please speak with your OGT because it's very, very important. And about OGT, we will have news about the next and the country partners for the in the summer peak in Winco, because Chris is doing chat, because what is happening from OGT point of view is that, as I was saying to you, like the process time and in general from opening, it's very, very different compared to OG and OGV. So for example, here for OGT teaching, we were expecting other results, other openings. Clear?
Clear.
Clear.
Question. Who of you is selling OJT teaching in now?
No, Roma Sapienza.
No, Torino.
No, no Federico.
Ok.
No, Pavia.
For the ones that has GT as a product, I really suggest you to sit down with your GT and start understanding how to sell like really now, because the peak of approvals for teaching is February. So we are in the middle of January, and if we don't start selling it now, we lose the peak. And the next peak for teaching is in July.
Okay,
thank you.
Okay. And again, how we can shape all this amazing information in our GTCM. Again, what is the GTCM? Is how we plan our in general activities. Each activity based on the customer persona we have in front need to be planned in advance, at least in multiple months, based on our goal, target, channel, and message. Of course, more detailed and more shape it is, better it is. Okay, now we go more deeply. Where we sell our products is based on our, through our activities. What will happen now, also based on the answers that you gave me when I was asking for questions, also during the newsletter, during the one-to-ones, during general our conversation, I decided to go more deeply on the UR part and giving you some tips about the online, because I think that during Planco we discussed a lot about physical part. So I think that especially UR is a channel that first, I think it's very, very important to understand it better. And second, I saw also that from your side, it's more difficult, tra virgolette, to understand. Okay?
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
The first thing, why university relation channel is very, very important? First thing, because if we are recognized and we are supporting from our university, it means that we are more reliable and we have more facilitation from them. At the same time, if we have good UR, like really being present at university, show more the importance of our association in general in our market. And last but not least, we have to remember that it's very important also that we do it with constancy and with very clear CRM. Definition of CRM is customer relation management, because in this case, in this type of channel, we can see that our customers are not just students. Like our main customer are students, but also like in general, young people, not just students, but also professors, because through them, they sell to the university student. Here, I put something that Manuela for sure knows. Here, this is a tool that in Roma 3 they are using to work with CRM. I can also share to you a link where Carlotta, she presented it during a webinar that we did with the current VPs about university relation. It's very, very important that to start understanding the university relation part, we will see that we have different types of activities that we can do in the university. The main activities are mainly based on professors, offices, departments. But the main step that we need to do to start is to have a clear target list. And to have a clear target list, we need to have a clear CRM that can start in the first tracker that is here. The yellow one is more based on the professor side, and the second is more. Side. Of course, here is empty. You have to have it full, because if you don't have it full, you don't start. And this is very, very important, because if you understand which are your current relationship with professors, that can mainly based on how clash outs went or how they didn't went, And if you have clear which is which word, like the current situation, for example, in the previous year, in terms of department, in terms of offices, you understand which to who give more priority. Okay, for example, with professors, if you know, like if here you have a list of professors that you put that are available to clash out, that I don't know, you went to the ricevimento and they are super supporting in general Isaac, that during the clash outs they leave you not just 10 minutes but also 15-20 minutes, that after that they spoke about you again. For sure that type of professor can be in the, at the beginning of the list. At the same time, what you need to have clear is in general which is your current and your past situation in terms of you are. This is very important. I don't know if you saw, I hope yes, in the checklist that I put for transition foreshadowing, I put also to have clear which is the current situation of you are, because you have to have clear what happened or what not happened in the past year. Not just in the past, but in 2 years ago. It's very important, like, it's very important to understand that, for example, if, I don't know, department economics, you think that can be a very cool department to approach, but if you don't have clear what happened in the past year, if they already approached them or they didn't, if you don't know if you had already in the past, I don't know, some newsletter with them, sort of opportunity with them, or if you don't know if the structure of the department changed from 1 year to the other, if you don't know that the responsible change, if, for example, you have a relationship with them and you didn't do the change of responsible from your current VPs to you, you have to do it. And this is very, very important. Okay. And in general, with offices and departments, my main suggestion is that is something that I don't know, Gabri, if you want also to tell something. But it's something that I was doing also with Gabri when I was in visiting Roma Sapienza. If you never worked with offices and departments, I suggest you to have a very big picture of your university website, for example, starting from that, mappatura, you say in Italian, a map of which departments you have, with what offices you have, which opportunities you have with each department, each office, and which tool you can use to put it down, you have on the evaluation stage. The first part of the evaluation stage was made also to help you with that. Because I think that is very, very important to have in general your current university relation clear. And my main suggestion, like we will see also later, and why for me it's a very, very important strategy, is because if you have like we really need to stop to use our relationship with the university as a plan B. We need to start using it as a plan A, because if we really start having
Georgia.
You cannot hear me.
Ok,
no,
yes.
Yes.
No, yes. Che disagio. Dove sei rimasti, raga?
No, oh. I think you are end.
Cos'è?
Penso che tu avessi finito, però c'era silenzio.
Ok. Avete sentito, did you hear about why it's important to not leave it as a plan B?
No.
Ok. This is very important. Now, I was finishing this part of CRM telling you that it's very important to not leave the university relation part as a plan B, because it's very, very important to understand that if we start using it as a plan A, also all the other parts would be easier. As I was saying, we will be more reliable. People will trust more on us. And also, for example, doing physical activities maybe will be easier. Do you hear him? Say no.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Very quickly, how to start, how to do, which are the steps to work in the university relation part. first thing, as I was showing to you, the target list with deadlines and priorities, doing the first contact, doing the execution of the meeting. Of course, Raga, if here you do the first contact and the professor, the office department, whoever doesn't answer you, of course, you have to continue following up. It's not that you, if you do a follow-up and after 1 week you don't answer, ciao, you leave there. Okay? The execution of the meeting, and it's very, very important that during the execution of the meeting, you go out of the meeting having clear which will be the activity that this person, this office, this department, this entity of the university will do. It's very, very clear to finish the meeting, understanding, okay, in parentheses, very important, approaching a meeting with university, it's very important that you don't go there with an approach, okay, this is what I want to do, and this is what I want to get, dot. It's very important that you go there with the mindset of collaborating with them, with the mindset of we decide together what to do. And this is very, very important. Together, you understand which type of activity or activities you can do together. Because in the end, you have to understand that both of us, Isaac and the university, we are working for the growth of the students. Important is the follow-up after the meeting or the touch point itself that you can do, can be a meeting or a call, whatever. It's very important that after that you send a mail, a recapping and writing down what you decide, who are you, what is Isaac. You can also put a booklet of Isaac. Yes, in general that. Last, it's not the last, the fifth point is the track of the activities. So you have to have clear after the follow-up and after the meeting when the activity will be done from the professor, and you have to track it and evaluate that. So understand what this activity is taking from you. And last but not least, to follow up. It's very important that you don't use a professor, an office, a department, a university in general, just when you need. But it's very, very important that you always care of your relationship with them. An example is also what happened, for example, in Napoli Federico II. They have this amazing opportunity with the newsletter from all the university, but they didn't use them for a lot of time.
Yes, it's right. But we do another email for another term.
Cos'è?
We do another type of mail.
Sì, sì, it's like a mail istituzionale.
Yes.
Sì, 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 I was telling as newsletter and a mail. That you, for example, you restarted to use it in when it was May, can be May, April, May, but before you stopped to use it. And for example, now it's something that you don't know neither how it started. And it's very, very important to never lose this relationship with each person you are talking with in your university background. Okay? Okay. Last but not least, okay, raga, sorry if I'm talking a lot, but I think it's very, very important that everyone of you have cleared all this your part. And last but not least, what are these activities that you can do? Very important is to understand that are activities done by these entities that I'm talking about, but the activities that they will do can be, as I was telling, from the university itself, can be a mail istituzionale, as they are doing in Napoli Federico II, can be, for example, a newsletter from a department, as they are doing, for example, I know, in Trento, can be the website sharing, as they are doing, for example, in Trento, they are doing in the website of the department, can be a publication under the Moodle learning, like in general, the portals that you are having, that can be both from the professor or from the department, can be in the Facebook page, are sharing made by professor, department, offices, or in general, the university itself.
Okay. These are the types of activity that you can do with these entities, NC entities, with these entities. And other type of activities that are all under the Universe Relation Channel are career days, and are very, very important, these career days for OGT, is the relationship with Rus. Question. Who of you knows what is Rus?
I don't know.
I heard about this, but I don't remember.
Someone else?
I know, no, Rus. I don't
know. Okay. Benissimo, ma non benissimo. I will show you what Rus is. So, mainly Rus is the Rete dell'Università per lo Sviluppo Sostenibile. This is the website, and mainly is a partner that we have in ISEC in Italy. Who is managing this partner at the national level is Jobbia. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
But we can exploit them also inside the university. Okay? And how can be doing events with them, creating relationship with specific professors that are working in this rete dell'Università per lo Sviluppo Sostenibile. And mainly, why are they very important and why you can really like exploit the work with them is because their main like objective is working in the SDGs. So it's like super connected with ISEC. And it's very, very important that you also go in this tool. This is why I was asking. I don't know if you were added from your current VP. I added some of you that were already elected when I created the both the tool and the group on Workplace. On Workplace, we have a group that is called Rus. Where it's both managed from me and Jobby. In the last publication that we did, we put this tool where you can see in each university where you can find Rus. And it's very, very important that you start approaching them. And in case, for example, one thing that, for example, Manu did, like, for example, now in transition with your current, you understand that you are having troubles in terms of answers from this professor, you should tell to me or to Jobby, because Jobby is communicating with the main responsible of Rus. Okay, and what we are working with her is that if, for example, we are having troubles in terms of cooperating with them, we have to tell her. And it's very, very important that also you upload this tool, because one important thing is that also through this cooperation, we can really understand how much we are big in terms of ISEC in Italy. Because what will happen is that also at the end of the year, this tool, what will happen this year, will be also released from the Rus side, and we will also understand how much our partnership was efficient or not. For example, one cool thing that was done all these things, Raga, I will send to you. This website, for example, one suggestion is that you also can see here all the events that they are doing around Italy, and you can also talk to them, write to them based on when they are doing the events, where, and if they are connected to... Yeah, they are connected to what we are doing. So in general, yes. And it's very, very important. All these tools, Raga, I will send you. This link is the website. And as I was saying, when, for example, if I can give you, Cristo Santo, an example, one very cool thing that they did with Ruth in Easy Roma Sapienza. I don't know, Gabri, if you know. Last year in May, Cesare, with, I think, the responsible of Ruth, they did this round of classes talking about the SDGs.
Yes, like, I know.
This round of courses talking about SDGs. And it's very, very important. With the responsible of Rus, you can do many, many different things. For example, also here in Venice, they were doing, they were working with Capote Sostenibile, that was until November was the main office. They were sending newsletter, for example, for them. I don't know if it was weekly or monthly newsletter. So you can really understand how to shape your communication with Rus in your local level. But I think it's a very, very important entity that you can use to work better in your university relations. Clear?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Yes. In general, three main clarifications about UR. And after I finish more or less with UR, because I could just speak about UR until the rest of my life, but it's okay.
Okay, in general, as I was saying you before, university relations are the activities are the ones done by the university entity, are not as sending the mail. So, for example, when you will see in Sona the question about how many university activities you did, are not the mails that you are sending to the professors, are the mails that you are sending to the... projects. Is the office...
Gio, non ti abbiamo sentita.
Raga, mi sentite ora?
Adesso sì.
Ora sì.
Cristoforo Colombo, sto cavolo.
Ciao, Gio. Io adesso ho team meeting, quindi vi saluto.
Va bene, dopo controlla la YouTube.
Ok.
Anyway.
Ciao.
In general, as I was saying before, university relations are the ones, the activities are the ones done by the university, it's not the when you sell the mail. Like, for example, is when the offices are publishing the project, when the, for example, the department is publishing an event. Like, very important, with the university itself, with the university relations activities, you do not have just to, they don't have just to publish projects, but they can publish events. They can publish isaac.it/the volontariato all'estero. They can publish the webs. They can publish like whatever. They can publish a booklet. Can be also of the, I don't know, the portfolio for GV Crea. GV, sorry, GV Scoping is GV Crea. They can publish each type of thing that you are offering them. This is very, very important. Again, as I was saying before, it's very important that you don't treat UR as a plan B, because it can really be a plan A. And a very important information about UR is that it's something important in general when you are planning, is that you have to take in consideration that in general university relation activities, the execution to have done them is not the same to have a clash out, okay? It's not that you send a mail to have a clash out 4 days before a clash out and you do it, because maybe you have to do a meeting with the professor. At least if you don't have already a collaboration, a professor promoter, they can take time to have the activities done, okay, the execution of the activities. It can take 1, 2, 3 weeks, it depends. At least, as I was saying to you, if you don't have, for example, something already that is developed, for example, it's happening in Roma 3, they are publishing, for example, in an office, in each week project, but they are having this relationship, something that they already planned since 1 year, more or less. Less than 1 year. Okay? And this is very, very important when you're planning your activities. Again, how to finish this part of UR. It's very important to work with UR also in integrated marketing. So to put UR as a channel when you are working in integrated marketing. For example, you are promoting, you are having an event in the middle of March under your, market economics, under customer persona sviluppa. And you need to promote an event that is the main event where you will convert all your leads. So the event will be what you will send to all your university relations entity that you have.
so to your professors in the economics faculty, to the department, the office, to whatever. Okay?
That's okay.
Okay.
Okay. And tricks, especially about Facebook sharing and Facebook ad. Like, I wanted to go more deeply on UR because I think it's something very important. And as I was saying to you before, I think it's something that I was feeling, and that, as you were telling me, something that you need to have more clear. So in general for online, now I will give you some tips. And in case, I will also send you the booklet about that I put in the academies, if you need to have more information. And in general, an important information that I told also during Planco, the ad management part will change and will be launched during Planco, during Wico, sorry. During Winco, we will explain how the ad management part will be changed. Will change. About in general online, also here, it needs to be connected to your GTCM. So you need to connect all the targets you are having for that week, that month, and to also put on your online channel plan. You have to have a very clear plan of a timeline in terms of activities, both Facebook sharing, both for Facebook ads, and both newsletter. It's very important to have a training in your area. And raga, you need to start using Photoshop. It's very important. Canva is not saving you. I know that Photoshop can be difficult at the beginning, but really is not impossible.
Hi guys.
As I was sharing to you in Planco, I learned Photoshop just doing it. I learned just because I needed to use it. I was a team leader at Mission, and I needed to create the contents because my VP, she was sending me the things in Photoshop, and anyway, I need to create content. I neither needed to know that Canva was possible to use, just to let you know. So it's very important that you start using Photoshop, also because it's really easier than Canva. It is more carino also. And in general, I can also share to you some trainings in YouTube, if you want, for both you and your team leaders and members. It's very important that you also execute the activities, of course, based on your target, the message and the channel. And of course, the methods needed to be connected based on the customer that you're approaching. You need to share the message based on the group you are promoting, based, you cannot put the same copy, for example, in all the Facebook sharing or in all the Facebook ads. And last but not least, you should evaluate your results. How to evaluate them? There are different ways to evaluate. From Facebook ad, the main resource to evaluate your results, for example, is Business Manager. For a Facebook sharing, you can use Bitly. You can use also the interaction that you are having under the Facebook group. You can, like, for example, very easy thing, you can also base it on the communication with your VP, OGX, so you can also understand based on the publication that you're doing on Facebook, how much of them are writing or calling to your VP based on the publication you are doing, and all this type of tracking. Important thing about Facebook sharing is, of course, having a clear calendar of promotion. I put you as example under the template of the tracking tool. Of course, you have to find the right group based on the right target. And of course, it's very important to refresh this group. If you see it after one month and a half, there are just your posts. I don't know how much it makes sense to continue posting on that.
Again, I put you that you can use Bitlis, as I was suggesting, for example, to Anto the other day. You can create Bitly based on projects, based on week, based on the Facebook group where you are sharing. There you can create the Bitly based on what you prefer. It's very important that you don't have a Bitly for everything, because then you don't track. A suggestion is to create, a suggestion can be that create a Bitly for group and you track it weekly. So weekly you see which is the result of this Bitly based on the post, on the group. Or also you can have, I don't know if some of you have some other GCPs about how you are using Bitly. Sì, no.
Sì.
How are you? Yes.
How?
Mm-hmm.
I use Bitly, for example, when I post on Facebook group, and I sometimes analyze if a post with for example, we have some group for the same target, from the same university, and I try to post on one a project with a photo, and on the other groups another project with another photo, and I try to analyze what kind of product or project or what kind of photo is more catch for this target.
Mm-hmm.
Basta.
Cool. Someone else? Raga? Okay, if there is no one else that wants to share, in general, ma raga, mi stai sentendo o c'è un disagio con il wifi?
Sì, no, okay. Almeno io ti sento.
Yes.
Okay, we are finishing, raga, don't worry. In general, other tips about Facebook ads. First thing, I don't know if all of you are clear, but I think yes, because our amazing Manu, she posts since, I think, 2 months ago, that in general the size of the ads are quadrate. Mm-hmm. And very, very important is to not to put less than 20% of text in the picture. If you don't know if you are putting less than 20% or whatever, of course also logos, there is a link that I can share to you where you can check if you are putting less or how much. Okay. Mm-hmm. And in general about
Joe?
About Facebook?
Joe?
Yes?
Repeat, please.
Which part?
In general about.
Okay. In general about Facebook ad, but about all, what I was saying about the 20%, or did you get it?
After the 30%.
Okay. What I was saying is that in general about both Facebook ad and Facebook sharing, it's very important to have a very, very clear and direct call to action. Call to action based on the copyright. The copyright, or that is the description, needs to be very clear. Of course, for example, the Facebook sharing can be very more specific because it's a Facebook group. Also, Facebook groups can be very, very specific. But also in the Facebook ads needs to be very aligned based on the market you're in front. If you do too much generic Facebook ads, it's not efficient. You need to retargetize your Facebook ad. And in general, what I suggest you, I put here also another link that you can check. It's the Bibbia of ads for Facebook, when you can go and check all type of contents to have a very cool cool Facebook ad. And in general, we will work on ads also, like I was telling you, we will give you more information about how to shape ads in Winco for the next semester, but it's very important to align ads in general about, to align the your ads to the brand of Isaac in Italy. So it's very important to not have random ads with random colors. This is not just for ads, but also in general from online. You really need to be aligned because at the end we are the face of our organization. So if we show different images to our customer, they will never understand who we are. Okay, this is very, very important. I can, this is can be based on the color, based on the font, based on the structure of the content, the structure of the image. It's very, very important to be aligned on that. Okay?
Okay.
Okay.
And for that, you can use both me and Marquezine, or also, like, for example, I was telling things for some of you. If you don't feel comfortable about how you are creating an image, how you are creating a copy, for whatever, you can use both me, Marquezine, but we can use the our WhatsApp group to share how we are working with that. Because I think it's very, very cool. Like, from my point of view, we can learn how to be brand aligned, also confronting and also comparing how they're working and giving feedbacks to each other. So we can also use our WhatsApp group. And again, also from online side, we need to be integrated marketing. Again, here, for example, I will give you again the example of an event. We have an amazing event on March, where we sell that also online, through we send a letter to all our all leads. We promote that, like, for example, we are promoting, for example, we are having an event for the customer persona sviluppa, and we are promoting on the Facebook group of economics, second year, blah, 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 blah. Also that we can promote, for example, a project, a smart project, and we tell, do you want to know more about this type of project or other type of project for you? Come and discover it in our amazing event. Ta-da! A link to the event. Okay?
Okay.
Okay.
And again, raga, GTCM is the way. If you have a clear GTCM, if you have clear for each campaign, for each
campaign.
You need to have very clear GTCM for, like, for each type of thing you're, like, not each type, but in general for each campaign you are approaching, for each week you are approaching. Like, for example, if, okay, cazzarola, raga, io non ce la faccio a non spoilerare di cose. Okay, if we have, we will have, as I was saying to you, we will work on waves, okay? When we will have a campaign of between February with the main peak of conversion in March, you need to have very clear the GTCM for February and the beginning of March, okay? Where the main call to action will be this conversion touch point that we'll have in March, okay? You need to have very, very clear the GTCM.
Okay.
Okay.
Va bene, Donzelli. We finished. I know that I spoke a lot. I hope it was useful, also because selling is very important. We can say ciao to everyone and interrompere la trasmissione. Aspetta, interrompi prima lo schermo. We can say ciao to everyone and interrompo.